Hello there, my name is Ivan Medov, I'm representing the company IT-Sputnik, and in this video I want you to show how you can set up a lead card, deal card, contact card, or company card, all of them setting up in the same way. And as an example, I will do that settings inside the deal card. So I go to that deal, and inside of that deal I got some information by default, right? And I got some sections. So first of all, that sections could be deleted or could be added. So you can create a new section and put in a name, and in that section you can add some fields, some custom fields or the default fields. And in default sections, if you click edit, you got some fields which is already coming by default. But when you, for example, creating the deal, you do not see all of them in the same order. So you can select fields you want to see when you're creating deal, and also when you editing a deal, some fields showing up only if you got data. But for example, for some reason you want to see a field if there is no data there. To show them, you need to click edit, click Jira here, and select show always. So that means that if doesn't matter if even that field will not have no data, it will be showing up. For example, you got a probability field which is empty, and you untick it to show always. So it's not showing because you have no data there. But for some reason you want to see them all time when you filling the data or just checking the deal itself. So you select show always in Jira with Jira wheel, click save, and that's it. That field became always available to view even if you have no data there. So as you see, there is some limitations of fields by default, but you can create a field yourself. But for that you need to have permissions. You should be an admin in a way to create such fields. So for that you need to create field and select type of field you want to create inside the video. There is one way you can do that. Also another way, you can go to the settings and go to form and reports, custom fields, go to the deal, and then you can click add field, then give a name. For example, it will be test field. Okay, also you can set up as a regular or multiple. So showing filters means that when you filter in the data, you can see that data is in filter as well, because some data could be as a technical some fields could be technical fields and you don't them to see each time. The same thing for the list. In that case, I will select a string, means that text field, or it could be any, like a boolean, number, date, money. So let's select string and put any default name value and click apply. That's it. So we got that field created, and we can see that field inside of a list. And using settings is better because you have a list of all custom fields, and you can navigate between them. When you're going back to deals, go inside of that deal and select. Click select field and select test field we created. Okay, so for example, And we also selecting that we need to see that field always, even if data is not existing inside of that field. Okay. And for example, we will try to save that deal if that field is empty. We click save. And you got a notification that field is missing. So you need to put some data there to save that data. So for example, put test and save. So we save that data. Also, you may do configuration of that field, custom field, and you can, in other words, you can change the name or make it required for some stages. For example, could be that field could be required for invoice stages, but will be not required for any other stages. So it means that if data is not exist, you will get a notification. For example, I will save that and I will delete that some data there. Okay. And for example, I'll move to invoice stage, but data missing. That's why I got notification. So this is for double check for your manager to put some data there. Also, because we select multiple fields, you can find you can put some other data there and save. So in our words, you got sections, you got default fields. You can move them to different sections in such way, or you can add some custom fields. You can create a new sections as well. Also, you can, as an admin, you can select that view for standard profile for all users. For example, you can create a custom view for particular user. For example, you click here and a new view, and you select and test view, or and you put any data, and select for user for which you want to set that view. For select user, save. So that user will see that view. If you, for example, do some changes, for example, delete sections, move around fields, you can create a new view for another user. Okay. And each user will see a different view. So very short, and in the same way you can do that in deletes, contacts, and companies. So if you have any questions, if I miss something, ask that question in comments below under that video. Or if you like the video, click just like. Thank you and bye-bye.